for the year 2010-2011 before this august audience. Father, please.
Most Reverend Dr. Albert de Souza, Archbishop of Agra and Chairman of the College, distinguished guests, fathers, sisters, well-wishers and parents. The academic year 2010-11 has gone by leaving behind a trail of events and memories for us to cherish and treasure. These events and happenings have given us an opportunity to take stock of the day-to-day activities of the college and to do things which have been left undone. We do everything in our college with firm determination, courage and crystal clear goals. When we look back and evaluate our performance of the year 2010-2011, we have abundant reasons to be proud. Though our students have done well, both at the academic and co-curricular fronts, we do not rest on our laurels. For us, the sky is the limit. The wall of purification, the yoga wall, is nearing its completion. This wall has an area of 6,402 square feet and 61 statues depicting various yogasanas. It is one of its kind in the world, and we are making our humble efforts to enter the pages of the Guinness Book of World Records. I am sure our efforts will bear fruit, and the people of the city can be proud of it. I request your prayers and support for it. We are grateful to the sponsors and the well-wishers who have contributed generously to make this wall and the main gate. This year, we have begun target classes with a view to improve the performance of the weak students. In all classes, Section A is kept as target class. The students in these classes will be given personal attention and coaching. Though there was some resistance from the teachers and the students, the demand to join these classes is on the increase. I am happy to say that the students are doing very well, and I am sure at the end of this academic year, they will come out with flying colors. I request you all to join yoga classes at St. Peter's College. The Archbishop Albert de Souza Yoga and Meditation Center is open to public every day except Sunday, 1 hour before assembly and from 5:30 p.m. to 7 p.m. Teachers trained at the Vivekananda Yoga University, Bangalore will be taking classes. It is only through yoga that you can lead a disease-free and tension-free life. Yoga makes you more adaptable to changes, makes you bend with the wind, enjoy the contest of life, and makes you feel in harmony with nature. I would like to quote H. Robbins, "Happiness and success in life are not the result of what we have in life, but how we live it."
Without reason, it is a temple of knowledge, and we, the Peterians, are keen to imbibe as much of it as possible.
2009-2010 were excellent. Out of 146 students who appeared for the IEC examinations, 15 students scored above 90%, 65 students scored above 75%, and the rest above 60%. Prof. Kumar topped the science stream, and Nikhil Jain topped the commerce stream. Our result, was declared the best result in the city by the Hindustan Times.
The ICSC 2010 batch of 194 students also brought in a 100% result, with 37 students scoring above 90%, 86 students above 75%, and the rest above 60%. Master Meghal Goyal topped the batch with 95.8%. This year, 134 students have appeared for the ISC and 225 students have appeared for the ICSC examinations.
With a heavy heart, we will reply to our former headmistress, Reverend Sister Basim. We will be forever grateful to her for the meritorious service she has rendered to this institution, a service she performed with love and dedication. We welcome into the St. Peter's family Sister Bridget as our new headmistress. She is dynamic and caring and has already established herself as an...
The scholastic year 2010 is a remarkable one, made memorable by the visits of prominent dignitaries from the city and outside. Mr. Vijay Kumar, IG Agra, was the chief guest for the 164th Annual Day 2010. The dance drama Pappa Jaldi Ajana was staged on this occasion. It dealt with the theme of declining social values and disintegrating family system, a theme extremely relevant in the high-tech, fast-moving modern world. At this annual function, the prestigious Archbishop's Gold Medal for the year 2010 was awarded to Anurag Saran and the Principal's Silver Medal to Shivastaram.
An extremely proud day for the college was 6 September 2010, when four illustrious alumni of the institution, Lieutenant General Bharatwaj, Lieutenant General Chandel, Lieutenant General A.K. Singh, and Lieutenant General D.S. Chauhan, once again walked in the corridors of St. Peter's, adorned its stage, and relived their experiences. Dressed in their military regalia, they were awesome. Our pride in them and in our college knew no bounds.
Lieutenant General A.K. Singh, who was the station commandant at Mathura, invited the staff and students of Class 12 to visit the cantonment. They got a rare opportunity to see the latest artillery, T-28 and T-92 tanks, and even the famous Bofors gun kept at the huge artillery depot there.
The annual cultural fest in St. Peter's is a time of exhilaration and excitement, of keen competition, laughter and tears. It was inaugurated by Reverend Father Sebastian Panthaladi. Days of hectic activity ended with an exciting and grand dance competition in which the dances matched the performance of professional dancers. Each day showed a multitude of talent in debates, dramas, declamation, quiz, song and dance.
In the primary and junior school, competitions helped to determine the best performing artist. Nishesh Agarwal was adjudged the Kala and Manan Singh the Kala Gaurav from the junior section. The entire fest was absolutely...
And for the first time, we were inspired by our principal to give this medal. After much deliberation, it was named Eternia 2010. St. Lawrence House became the winner of this cultural fair to Eternia 2011. The crowning glory for us was the privilege of welcoming Lieutenant General A.K.S. Chandel, AVSM, PDSM, ADC and ex-Pretorian as the chief guest for our Aero Sports and Athletic Meet. There were athletic events, aerobics, yoga, motorcycle gymnastics and dance performances, which were exciting and breathtaking. St. Francis House emerged the overall champions. And finally, the day ended on a spectacular note of the evening sky.